Yvette Nicole Brown. Yes, and I am here to moderate a panel for the wonderful show Wednesday. So let me tell you this. In its first 4 weeks, Wednesday became the second most viewed English language series in Netflix history. Yes, it amassed more than 1.2 billion hours of viewership, making it the third title to ever reach this milestone within that time frame. It has been nominated for 16 awards and won 6 for many of its iconic elements. Okay, so here we go, guys. This series is a sleuthing, supernaturally infused mystery, charting Wednesday Addams' years as a student at Nevermore Academy. You know, it's all this stuff that she's going through and we get to see it. So I want to bring out these people so we can talk about everything. Let's start with the wonderful woman that plays the principal, Larissa Weems, Gwendoline Christie! Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. And next we have the Morticia Addams, the Catherine Zeta-Jones. Check out the outfit, check out the outfit. Next, he embodies the icon, Gomez Addams, Luis Guzmán. Next, she is the music supervisor of this great show. Please welcome Jen Malone. Hey, Jen. Ooh, I love the jacket, girl. He is the composer extraordinaire. Please welcome Danny Elfman. Now, these next two are the creators, the writers, and executive producers. Please welcome Miles Millar and Al Gough. Next, she is a legend of costume design, the Colleen Atwood. Is that everybody? We have every... Oh, no, there's one more that we're all waiting to see. The last, but never the least, Jenna Ortega, Wednesday Addams herself. Hey! Hi, Funkin. Hi. All right, well, I want to start with Al and Miles. Huge congrats, by the way, on Wednesday. It is Netflix's huge hit. The Addams Family is one of the most universally known and beloved series. So what made you say we need a teenage Wednesday and we want to see how she goes through all of that? How did you decide to change the vision of the show in that way?
Well, we always loved the Addams Family, and Wednesday was always our favorite character. But we wanted to tell a chapter in her life that no one had ever seen. So we'd always seen her as a girl, and we thought, well, what if she was a teenager? And then what if she was in boarding school? And then we sort of went back and forth if she should be in normal people boarding school or a special boarding school for outcasts. And ultimately, we thought if she was in a regular school, she would just blow through them, which is basically what she did in the first 5 minutes of the show. So we wanted to put her in a place of outcast, but even in that school, she is the most outcastiest of outcasts.
You want to add to that, Miles?
Yeah, I think also was the idea of doing a supernatural show with comedy was something that really interested us. And this is something that was very unique about Wednesday, her unique black humor. So it was just finding something or finding an iconic character like Wednesday, but as Al said, finding a new way into her story.
Jenna. Hi, Jenna.
Hello.
Now, you are getting used to playing iconic characters in movies and television shows that people already know. What is it like to take a character that's already been out there and make it your own?
It's definitely a lot of pressure, I would say, especially because Wednesday has been done perfectly multiple times by other really, really incredible performers. So I think that there's definitely how do I even compete with that? One. But then two, how are you supposed to welcome this character to a new generation but still make her familiar for older generations? So it definitely was the balance of, okay, well, how much liberty do I have as an artist to, you know, create new traits and new bits of personality and different sides of her while still weaving in nostalgic aspects of previous iterations so that it's kind of acceptable and familiar to everyone? And empowering to everyone. So I think that there was definitely a lot to that. And then also, we've never spent so much time with Wednesday before. She's typically the one line, you know, end of a joke. So it was really, really interesting to have to give her a little bit more dimension or to be I guess, yeah, just see more vulnerable sides of her, or things that we had never seen from her before.
Mm-hmm. Gwendoline, your Larissa is both strict and in charge, but she also has a little soft spot for Wednesday. So how do you straddle the fence and find a way to make both sides of her real?
I just immediately adored Larissa Weems for all of those conflictions in her personality. A woman that's really put together, but is also deeply vulnerable and really trying to make things work, and really being deeply challenged by this new student who is also the child of an old nemesis. So that's already a hotbed of things to kind of get you going as an actor. But very honestly, just going into a scene with Jenna, there was so much already there between us that was quite unspoken. And I felt truly honored to work with an actor who was willing to go to so many different places and be respectful and have an extremely, genuinely dark sense of humor and allow this very weird relationship to take place.
Which is actually mirrored in you guys. You guys should have seen the way they greeted each other in the back. It was so sweet. There was a bowing involved, and it was a lot of stuff. I loved it. Catherine Zeta-Jones, hello, dear. I did a little research, and I heard that you don't always like to see a role that someone else has portrayed before you played it. Was that the same for Morticia? Did you think, maybe I won't look and see what they did? Or were you a fan and you couldn't avoid it?
Yeah, well, like in Chicago, I never saw the music. I'm a musical person. I never saw it. So when I started that, I was like, well, why see it now? Because it's a different world, you know? So, but with Morticia, she was so kind of embedded in my subconscious. Like, so many of us on a huge generational, scale, that I just knew that, first of all, I would have so much fun playing her. And then I got to find out he was going to be my hubby. And I'd read the phone book with this guy if they asked me to, because I adore him. And then it was just like the perfect storm. When Tim Burton called to say, hey, and Miles and Al, we had that first conversation. It's like, when do I turn up? When do I start? You know, it was one of those. And then to get to have this fantastic talent, Jenna, just, you know, working with her was just phenomenal. And the whole piece, which was so great, just from reading the first few episodes, it was taking iconic characters and bringing them into this day. You know, so many women I know go, oh my God, do I have a Wednesday at home? Because they know that mother-daughter dynamic. And even though we have these iconic characters that are, you know, people dress up as Halloween as these characters, there was something very rooted and real about all of us in this crazy world. And the emotions were real, you know, and I think that was so, so much fun.
And it's on the screen. Luis, people may not know this, but you started your career as a social worker. I thought that was so fascinating. So I wanted to know, is there something from that season of time in your life that colors how you choose characters, how you plan to do your characters? And did you use some of that, what you learned in crafting your Gomez?
Well, with this character, it was about being a dad. So I'm a dad. And I had to take on the different levels of Gomez and he's a little awkward, but he means well all the time. And he's very passionate about his beautiful wife, loves his daughter, his son. And so I just use my life as my reference to the character. And I mean, look, I grew up watching The Addams Family when it was in black and white. I saw it when Raul Julia did it in the film. And then getting the call from Tim Burton, which I didn't believe it was Tim Burton, but it was Tim Burton. And I got to tell you a funny thing. So these two guys here, they were on the Zoom, and it's like, but they weren't saying anything. And then when I met them, and I said, oh, you guys are the brains behind the writing. I got to tell you, this is one of the best shows I have ever worked on. And I was really proud of that. And you know, again, working with Catherine, working with Jenna, you know, it was like so enlightening to me because it was like a breath of fresh air, you know, and just exploring it, making it mysterious. It wasn't slapstick, but it was funny. The situations were beautiful. You know, the sets, the costumes. Yeah. You're next, okay? And and like I say, you know, the whole effort that was put all around by Tim, by our writers, by our cast, by our background people, by all those people that did the costumes and the set and the wigs and the makeup, it just brought Wednesday to life as it should be. And I'm very proud of it. And like I said, I still pinch myself because, like, wow, I got to play one of the most iconic characters that I have ever grown up to see, and here I am. And
played him well. Yeah. Played him well.
Thank you.
Yes. Hi, Colleen. The costumes on this show are almost their own character. They are amazing. Yes. Can you speak a bit about what you wanted to capture with each character's looks on the show?
I think between the great script, which is really one of the best scripts I've ever read, bar none, that they came to life on the page in a way that they hadn't ever really done to me. And then the casting was so brilliant. As I met each one, and, you know, with Tim's eye and Tim's take on things, it really fell into place in a fun way for me. Each person was a real person that you could believe in. And once you know that, then dressing them is not the hardest part. It's finding them. But once they're dressed, it's, you know, then you're on a roller coaster.
Yeah. Danny. Hi, Danny. Yes, Danny Elfman. Now, you have obviously been behind so many iconic scores, and this is no different. What did you draw inspiration from scoring a television show for the first time?
Well, I have so much respect for television composers now, because I've written themes for television shows over the years, but I've never actually done episodes, and it's hard work. But, you know, it was pure fun when Tim called and told me, oh, I'm thinking of working on The Addams Family. Rather, I've gotten so many calls for him over the years describing so many strange things. This time I was like, dude, what took you so long? And I've worked on a few dark comedies, so it's just an area that I'm really happy and comfortable in. And it was just pleasure, you know. It's like, oh, this is going to be so fun. I grew up on The Addams Family, and it's like, it was just like sweet. That's the best way I could describe it.
Sticking with music. Hi, Jen.
Hello.
Hi, honey. Following the premiere, The Cramps' Goo Goo Muck went viral, with streams skyrocketing to introduce a new generation to the song. So why was this song the perfect song for Jenna's dance moment? And did you expect that kind of response? Did you hear it and go, this is going to go viral?
Well, I think when we start a show, my co-supervisor, Nicole, and I, we make a giant Spotify playlist of different songs, tones, moods, characters. And the Cramps were in there from day one. They're known for that, you know, dark, goth, psychobilly, punk. So it really fit in well with our world. And then with Goo Goo Muck kind of having that catchy hook, the spooky lyrics, and just interesting, fun rhythm, knowing that there was going to be a dance put to it was kind of, it was just one of those moments of like, no, this is great. I knew when the cut came in and I saw it, I knew that it was very special and people were going to have a lot of fun with it, but I had no idea it would blow up the way it did. It was pretty insane to watch.
Yeah, it was amazing to watch for us. The Addams Family cast members, you guys have a rapport that is magical. It's like you've always been together. What was it like when you first got on set? Did you guys know each other? Some of you may have known each other before. How did you get that immediate connection as a family?
Well, I personally had the opportunity to work with the best in the business. I think that the first time Tim even mentioned Catherine Zeta-Jones and Luis Guzmán, it was like, oh yeah, obviously. Like, there's a kind of no other way that you could do it. And there are people that I've watched growing up my entire life and admired and respected your guys' work for so long that I think that I was almost, I was really, really looking forward to actually shooting the Addams Family scenes, because I had a feeling that, you know, typically when you work with people who are so gifted at what they do, they almost push you to be better and engage in a way. And I think I was excited to kind of have that that creative connection with somebody or instinct. And yeah, with them, they're such sweet, lovely, kind, just really actually parental people in general. I feel like you guys definitely take people in and are like a comfortable source or like a safe space that I think it was very easy for me to, weirdly enough, be really nasty towards them as a teenage girl.
How about you two?
Well, for us, we did a movie called Traffic together.
Yes, you did. Like, yes, 20,
you did. Yeah, 20. I know exactly when it was because I was pregnant with my son, and he's 24 in August. So, and this guy rubbed my toes when my feet were all swollen and puffy. And I was married at the time, so it was just apt that he was to be my husband at some point. But it's so funny because we had never seen each other since the promotion. How has that happened, like 20-odd years? And so when we got together on the set, it was just like it'd been 2 weeks or something, you know? And then this beauty here. I mean, I've been loving her work forever. And we did a few scenes together, and I just relished them. But I think it really comes from the helm. When Tim cast this, he did it with such genius and very specific. And I think from there, it's an automatic gel, you know. And I worked with Colleen for many times, and it was just a lovely experience all around.
We complemented each other so well, and it was really like a family, you know. And we always looked at each other and for each other's honesty and quackiness, if I could use that term, like I say, it was all complimentary, what we did for each other, for the roles, for Wednesday. And I also got to say, I mean, Tim Burton. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's like working in Tim Burton universe and saying, okay, you are a fearless leader, but just remember, this is the family and we'll kick your butt. No, we won't do that. But it was just great showing up every day to work and doing what we did and just kind of spreading that love and the challenges of having a daughter, you know. But it was overall really great quality experience of growth.
Yeah, you kind of went to my next question for me. I wanted to ask the cast about being in the Tim Burton universe. Gwendoline, can you talk about that, what it was like to step into his world? Because he's like the master of all things spooky.
I have wanted to work with Tim Burton ever since I can remember. I was 6 when I saw Pee-wee's Big Adventure. That was a moment for me. And I thought, I remember, I said out loud, Tim Burton. Who is this Tim Burton? And then I watched everything that he did. And you know, for someone that's always felt outside, an outsider and had that feeling, there was this voice that told me that they had experienced the same thing. And it was not only okay, it was fabulous, it was hellish, and it looked glorious. But more than anything, it had a deep and resonant humanity. It was real, and it had a universal connection to it. So I was walking through a field when I got a text saying, "Hi, Gwen, Tim Burton would like to speak to you about his new project." And I think I evaporated. I just diffused. And then I had to do the Zoom, and I was a mess. And Al will tell you, I was bright red and frankly weird. But they cast me anyway. And then I had to try and bring some kind of performance with quite genuinely, and I know actors say this all the time, but honestly, with true legends and icons, yes, who are masters of their craft, yes, with the writers, with Danny, with Colleen, with Tim, and it was a huge honor for me, and it was honestly a dream come true. And every day, no matter what was going on, was so thrilling and satisfying for me. And also, these people gave me the huge privilege of allowing me to transform in a way in which no one else had ever seen me.
True.
So it was wonderful.
True, true, true. Anyone else want to touch on that Tim Burton situation?
Well, I said, that first Zoom, and it's like, I didn't know what I was going to get, because I always heard stories about Tim Burton. And then he comes on, and it's like, oh, shit, it's Tim Burton. And he's like, yeah, man, you know, I'm doing this thing. And it was like, it wasn't about what he was doing. It was about how cool he was, how cool his presentation was. I wasn't even listening. And then he goes, would you like to be my Gomez? And I go, oh, yeah, about that. Yeah. Yeah. You know, but, and then just working with him on set, he was just, you know, he would just come and give you little snippets, but you would, I would observe him and how he would work with his camera crew, how he would look at things. And it was like, you know, it's great to watch a sensei, you know? And I was just so honored, so thrilled to be working. And like I say, a really cool, down-to-earth guy.
I love it. This is a free-for-all for anyone who wants to get in here. Do you guys have a favorite episode from the series, or what's something that sticks out for you, the creators, or Colleen, or even Danny, Jen? Yeah, anyone, get in here. This is a free-for-all.
I mean, you know, for me, it's the first episode was like, because that was getting out of the box and getting the whole feel and the tone of it. So, you know, that was the favorite for me, you know, just getting those first lines and tasty little tidbits of like what's going to make this work. It was just so much fun.
Anyone else want to get in there? Yes.
I think seven for me, which is Uncle Fester Comes, which is already just like, Fred is amazing. It's just like a breath of fresh air at the end of the season. So, you know, unexpected.
How about you, Al?
I still the first one for me, I think. Yeah.
Jenna, you went in. I can see it.
Well, I was just going to say, I feel like episode 103 is kind of underrated just because there's that explosion with the statue and we get that awesome cello piece. There's the god-awful pilgrim costume. Thank you so much. There's the fight sequence. There's a lot of Eugene, who is just the funniest guy of all time, in my opinion. I don't know what it is. I think that Tim thought the whole pilgrim scheme was hilarious. And we also shot it midway through, so I felt like everyone kind of found their footing and was in the groove of things by the time we shot that, so everything felt really good.
Mm-hmm. Anyone else? Yes, Jen, you got one?
I loved all of the cello performances.
Yes.
Because I started learning cello after the Paint It Black.
Isn't it incredible?
I heard it and I literally was like, I want to do this. And I'm really bad. And so how you did it, after
they didn't release the actual footage. Audio.
They did. It's all her.
Yeah, I did that all with my eyes closed.
My teacher in the cello community, so you know, like A+.
Oh, thank you.
Bravo.
Yeah, that was insane.
Go on and clap. That's a clap. She did a great job. What do you guys hope that the fans get from this show? Because it's got that wonderful taste of nostalgia, but it's also a brand new version of this for all of us. So what do you want us to take away from all the beauty that you guys have created?
I think more than anything, especially in a time where social media is so influential on young people and anyone really, I think that it's really important that, you know, people stay away from kind of the bandwagon mentality and think for themselves and are original and embrace everything that they naturally have to offer. But I also believe with this show, it's a great opportunity to just kind of forget everything else. I think it's really important that we almost don't take ourselves too seriously, which again is a big, I think that's actually something that Wednesday struggles with, and we're noticing in real time with this character. Is I think that she's almost a bit too much of a perfectionist or anything like that. But honestly, with the show, I just want people to be able to kind of relax. It can be a really dark, scary place out here. So I think it's cool that people are able to turn on a show and watch werewolves and vampires and just pretend like this is all real for a second.
Anyone else? Yes, Catherine.
For me, I think what was, well, first of all, the phenomenon. I'd like to thank the fans, actually, because you guys have really become like serious fans. And it's just for us, as you know, on the other side of the lens, it's just so thrilling to see how it impacted everybody. For me, what stood out about the show was the love. You know, we're all quirky. We're all a little outcast. The Addams family is the ultimate dysfunctional family, and it seems to work perfectly. And for all those out there who feel a little quirky, or feel a little outcast, or feel a bit dysfunctional, it works. It can work, and it works beautifully, and I think it all stems from love.
Anyone else?
Yeah, I just like to say that it's about you don't have to fit in because you're different, but you're beautiful. You're beautiful how you come, and to take pride in yourself. You know, that's like a message that I would say out to young people, because it's always like, oh, I don't fit into this crowd or that crowd. But this show, that it's like, it's okay to be your own person and to love yourself and to respect yourself and to explore stuff. And it's like I say, it's not about fitting in, but just loving yourself and knowing you have a mom and a dad that love you and struggle with you and you struggle with them. But at the end of the day, it's family, it's love. Again, it's something beautiful and pure.
It's the heart of a social worker talking right there. See, he understands, loves people. This is the last question I have. Wednesday Addams is a Latina. And here's the thing, guys. She's always been a Latina. Let's talk about that, little one.
Okay. Well,
we're leaning in now. Let's do it.
Yeah, no. The first thing that it's pretty incredible that we're actually both Boricuas on our side. Yeah, that's pretty cool. That was like a nice little outing, because oftentimes they cast people and it almost doesn't match up. But that's pretty cool to not only be able to work with other Latin actors, but with someone like Wednesday. A big part of the reason why I actually took the role, aside from Wednesday being a legend and the script being enticing and all of that, I think for me it was the opportunity to. I can't really think of any other Latin character that has the reach that Wednesday does, or the impact, or the love or community that she has. And oftentimes, I Latin characters are the sidekick, or the daughter of the cartel leader, or like the housekeeper. It's true. It's a lot of the scripts that I've gotten are very stereotypical, or their heritage is their entire personality, and they have to carry their flag. So I think it was really, really empowering and incredible to get this opportunity. And I also like give a lot of respect and appreciation towards Netflix, because they made it very clear from the beginning when this project came around that they wanted her to be Latina, which I thought was really, really cool to just kind of set the standard and solidify that. But for me, yeah, I love Wednesday because she's weird. People still fall in love with her. They're obsessed with her. But then also she has this bit of representation that I never really had, growing up and watching TV. And I remember even when I was younger, Wednesday Addams came up in conversation, because I used to do this show where I played this kid. There was 7 kids, and I was in the middle, and I called myself Wednesday in the show, and I remember telling my mom, oh, remember? Wednesday, isn't that crazy? What if I played Wednesday Addams one day? And we both just kind of brushed it off, because we thought that there was never a possibility that they would cast me as Wednesday. So I think that it was just kind of a full circle moment, and then also a really great opportunity to give other young Latin people the opportunity to see themselves in such a well-respected character.
Well, yes. I gotta tell you guys, I watched the show in one weekend, like 2 days, a day and a half. I just watched it and fell in love. I am so honored that I got to sit here with all of you and celebrate you. And I hope that all of you that are voting members of the Emmys will keep all of these wonderful people in mind, because they are so well-deserving. Thank you for the time, my loves.
Thank you.